Okay, so the battery ran out, so I had to stop that video, and I had to eat the food because it was getting cold. So anyway, I'm almost finished, and I just want to finish it off. What I was saying about chocolate is that the lower percentage of cocoa chocolates, they taste fantastic, but you really want to stay away from them because they're not going to be as power-packed with these flavanols. And they're going to be high in sugar. Okay, so you want to go with a very high, 85% cocoa like this, 85 or higher of the the more higher quality brands, and limit your serving size, that kind of thing. And it's a little bit bitter, but you get used to it and you start to like that. So it's not quite as sweet. But it is fantastic when you get used to it. And it's not bad even when you're not used to it. But as far as standard chocolate, milk chocolate, don't even consider that as having any value. That stuff is so watered down, and there's not much cocoa in it, and it's very high in sugar, so that stuff is out. Okay, I just want to talk briefly about fat. You notice that my plate had a lot of fat on it in the form of nuts, olive oil, chocolate, and beef. The beef I have is somewhat lean, not very fat, but these are good fats. So good fats are okay. Good fats are fats that are low in saturated fat and high in unsaturated fat. And this the two kinds of unsaturated are mono and poly. Walnuts are a source of high polyunsaturated fat. They're mostly polyunsaturated, which is very good. I don't know why. You'd have to do some reading. I'd have to refresh what I read about it once, but it's one of the special things about walnuts is that they're high in polyunsaturated. Monounsaturated is still good for you. They do have some saturated fat, but it's only about 10% of the total amount of fat is saturated. So this is the olive oil that I use. Okay, it's a high quality. It's extra light. This is the kind you would use if you're going to cook with it. You should not use standard oil, standard olive oil for cooking because it has a low smoke point. So you want to research that more if you do want to cook with olive oil. But you should use the extra light. I use it with, even though I don't cook, because it's less bitter, it's nicer tasting to me. So I can have more, and it's more enjoyable for me. Even though it's extra light, doesn't mean it's watered down or anything like that. It's just processed in a different way, and it still has all those great benefits. Okay. About the fat in this is high in monounsaturated fat. It's 14 total grams of fat per serving, but only two of which are saturated, the 10 of which are monounsaturated. So these are good fats, and they're heart-healthy fats. So these are fats that are not, the unsaturated fats are not fats that are going to cause cholesterol and things like that. In fact, they seem to raise your good cholesterol, HDL. Okay, so that's why nuts and olive oil are good for you. Chocolate gets a pass on its amount of saturated fat because, as I said before, it's a friendly kind of saturated fat that does not contribute to heart disease and heart problems. Another thing about the omega-3 that you get from walnuts, and by the way, this is what the bag of walnuts looks like. It's a pretty big bag when it's full, and it costs around $7, something like that, per bag. So this stuff is still a little expensive, but it's worth it. The omega-3 breaks down into different types of acids, I guess, amino acids, and DHA is one of them. So DHA is excellent for, I guess, development of nervous tissue, things like brain and eyes. So it's very important to have in your diet for people of all ages. And as I said before, walnuts are one of the few non-fish sources of this fantastic type of omega-3. So that's why I'm big on walnuts. But you want to have all kinds of nuts, unless you're limited by oxalates, in which case you shouldn't. But all the nuts are good for you, and it's a good idea to rotate them. It's always a good idea to rotate, or, you know, the types of foods you eat within each food group. So I guess that's it. I am a proponent now of the low carb diet. If you, by the way, if you do want to go very low carb, which is to put you into ketosis, which is this fat burning state for energy, you can't have the chocolate. Even though there's a small amount, not a small amount, but even though there is carb in here, even though the carb level in here is small or lower than normal for chocolate, it's still too much. You have to limit your daily daily carb intake to 25 carbs a day. And that meal that I showed you earlier had about 20 carbs in it alone. So that's a low carb meal. That's not a very low carb. If you want to go very low carb, you can't have the berries and the chocolate. You'd have to leave that out to achieve ketosis. You eat a diet like that for about 3 or 4 days, maybe a week, and you would go into ketosis.